Oh no! Nemo has gone missing again. This time, his friends are going to use nature-inspired artificial intelligence to find him. Will they succeed? I'll visually explain all the steps they follow. And at the end of the video, I'll show you a computer simulation of the process and share a Python code of the entire procedure. So stay tuned. Our hypothetical situation goes as follows. Dory says to Marlin, "Marlin, I think we're gonna do it again." Dory, I don't know what's the matter with my son. What do we know so far? All what we know is that he's in the deepest point in the ocean. So let's assume that this rectangle is the ocean. The darker the color, the deeper the ocean is. The only information we have is that Nemo is in the deepest point of the ocean. That means he's there. And as you might have guessed, the white color indicates shallower depths, so the ocean goes deeper in this direction. In real-life scenario, this ocean bed could represent any function that you need to maximize. More on that at the end of the video. The deepest point? That's not helpful, is it? We don't know where that is. It could be anywhere in this vast ocean. Does that mean we need to search every single point in the ocean? Well, I've been studying AI, and I'll use one of its techniques. It's called swarm intelligence. Swarm intelligence? Does that mean we need to call our friends? Swarm, assemble. We are happy to help. Hey food, friends. Just kidding, happy to help too. Right, let me walk you through the steps. This method requires that we collaborate with each other. Hear me out. First, we will spread randomly across the ocean. Sorry to interrupt, but where should we be heading? North? East? At what speed? Everyone will choose a random direction and speed too. Each one of us will be in a new location based on the direction and velocity they've chosen. Please don't tell me that we need just to keep swimming in that random direction. I think we should communicate the deepest location everyone experiences, aka the best location, and all should head to that location and exploit it.
I disagree with you. If we do so, we all will end up at the same place. True that we move to a better location, aka deeper, but it's not necessarily Nemo's location.
Okay, let's get back to where we were.
Nonsense, right? I believe every one of us should remember the best personal location he experienced as a backup plan and keep exploring. He gets a better location, then that's okay. If not, at least he knows a better location.
Did I say, remember?
Good luck with that, Dory.
What Bruce is trying to say here is that these are his three locations, starting from the orange square. His first location happened to be his best location, as it coincides with a deeper, darker cell. Not funny, Bruce. Actually, all of you are quite right and wrong. Let me explain. Our next move should take into consideration the three things you mentioned: the best global location, the best personal location, and the individual momentum.
Well, that's confusing. Where should I go?
Let me explain. The movement should follow this logic. Our next location involves taking the current coordinates and adding a small step in the x direction. This will result in the current x-coordinate value being increased or even decreased by our next step in that specific direction. Let's refer to this step as delta x. So what exactly is this delta x? It's composed of three parts. The first part, indicated as green here, is the inertia, which corresponds to the previous momentum. Essentially, this implies that you should replicate the same step you took previously. In your case, Bruce, your last location, marked in green, was one step to the left. Let's add some approximate coordinates here to make the calculation a bit easier on us, which is 1.5 minus 2.5. This indicates that the inertia component should mirror your previous step, a single step to the left. Likewise, in the y direction, it's a step and a half downwards, 0.5 minus 2. The second component in the delta x is what's referred to as personal influence, highlighted in orange here. This signifies that your upcoming step should be adjusted toward the best location you've ever achieved, the orange square. This is quantified by finding the difference between the best location, the orange square, and your current location, which amounts to 4 minus 1.5
equals 2.5 to the right. Similarly, in the y direction, it's 3 minus 0.5 equals 2.5 upwards. The third and final component is the social influence, highlighted in red. Essentially, this implies that the subsequent step should be influenced by the best location ever achieved by the entire swarm, the deepest point that the swarm found, the red square in this case. And this is determined by calculating the difference between the global best, the red square, and the current location. So it's 2.5 minus 1.5 equal 1 to the right. Similarly, in the y direction, it's 7 minus 0.5 equals 6.5 upwards. I'm not finished yet. Instead of simply combining these components by addition, we might need to assign them different weights. In literature, it's common to further break down personal and social weights into components like R1 times C1, R2 times C2, where R1 and R2 represent a random factors introduced to add an element of randomization to the algorithm, where C1 and C2 stands for the personal and social weights. Changing these weights affect the entire behavior of the swarm. At the end of the video, I will show you three cases where I magnify one component at a time. So let's plug in some weights here and perform the calculation. Bruce, your movement should be 0.07 step to the left and 1.22 step upwards. And we keep iterating till we reach the deepest point. Let's go find Nemo. In this simulation, these 7 points represent the swarm. The red star represents the best global position. And as you see, it gets updated at every iteration. The yellow dot, though, indicates the best personal position, while the gray arrows show the position in each iteration. You can find the code in the GitHub repo mentioned in the description below. And as you can see, the swarm successfully finds Nemo after 33 iterations without having to search the entire ocean. Yay, we found Nemo! Thank you guys for finding me. I promise this is the last time to get lost. Please don't forget to subscribe to this channel if you are interested in learning how the different weights will affect the swarm behavior. Please keep watching. A swarm with high inertia weight will cause individuals to maintain a greater portion of their historical velocities, promoting stability in their movement trajectory. A lower weight, though, encourages individuals to change direction more frequently and explore different regions. On the other hand, a swarm with a high personal influence weight places more emphasis on individuals' historical successes, encouraging them to explore areas close to their previous best positions. A lower weight, though, promotes exploring and encouraging individuals to venture further into the solution space. And a swarm with a high social influence weight leads individuals to converge more quickly towards promising areas of the search space. However, a lower weight emphasizes individual exploration, allowing them to explore the solution space more broadly. The combined effect of these weights shapes the balance between exploration and exploitation in the particle swarm optimization algorithm. Adjusting these weights allows for fine-tuning the algorithm's behavior to suit the problem at hand, but there is a risk of getting stuck in the local optima. A greater focus on exploration might lead to a broader solution space coverage, but slower convergence. The optimal values of these weights often depends on the specific problem and requires experimentation to find the right balance for efficient optimization. And don't forget what Nemo says, please subscribe and hit that like button.